Welcome to Nogmile 2K14.
We're on site here at the Tristan Laughlin Memorial Track.
Me and my buddy Cedric here are going to bring you a preview of the Nogmilers in 2014.
First up, we've got the Nogmiles' first ever champion, Harrison Larman. He also happens to be a founder of this fine event, and he's always out there to compete, and I don't expect any different from him this year. Probably gonna go out there and do the best he can to win this motherfucker.
Another person bound to be a contender this year is Luke Embry of the North in Kansas. He finished third last year in a respectable time, and I expect the same this year. You got it, Luke.
It hurt!
Next up, one hell of a runner, Adam Treadway. He took second in 2012, then he disappeared for a year. Some say he went and trained with AE Dairy. He has become one of the best egg milk guzzlers in the country. And I expect him to come here and dominate this race. You heard it first from my lips.
Message approved by Cedric Gibbs. Another Nog guzzler that's going to be on the track this year, we have NAU's very own Caleb Hoover. He was recently an All-American in Terre Haute, and he's been an All-American in Eugene on the track. But will he be All-AE Dairy in 2014? Rumor has it that he's going to break the course record by 20 seconds. Now, if he does, that puts him really close to the 5-minute barrier. It's never been broken.
Now last year, an intense rivalry was born. Right here, on this very track, the Tristan Laughlin Memorial Track. Let me take you back, about a year ago, last lap, Eggnog Mile 2013. Now John Speed Williams was about 150 meters back of the finish line, and there was one man between him and glory, and that one man was Jay-Z. Now, we all know that John Speed Williams has a kick, a devastating kick. But he's too far back, right? He can't catch Jay-Z. Jay-Z's going into the final turn, going into the home stretch, and he's still back at the 200 meter mark. Right, he's gone. He's done, right? Well, you're wrong. You're completely wrong. He starts gunning for it. You look at him, you're thinking, man, this guy's an animal. He's a monster. Is he even human? Probably a cyborg, more like it. And we see him, and he's got this fire. You can just kind of see a red tint in his pupils. And he's just burning for it. He's gunning. He pulls even with Jay-Z about 50 meters back from the finish line. And they're just going back and forth. John, Jay-Z, John, Jay-Z. And next thing you know, John just digs one more time and boom! Done. Finished. Legacy. Glory. Gold. And who knows what's going to happen this year? It's probably going to be even crazier. Who knows? I, for one, am expecting some hardcore blood. There's going to be blood on that track, ladies and gentlemen. You don't even know what this means to the sport, what this means to this race. We're going to find out what happens when John Williams meets Jay-Z for part two of their rivalry.
Thank you, Cedric. Truly a heartwarming and inspiring story. But now to talk about possibly the most important man in this race, the man, the myth, the guinea pig. Mr. Sam Gwynn. He's run 5:21 twice to take the championship. First year, great condition. Second year, below freezing and sleeting. Sub 5 could be in the cards this year. Only time will tell. But I know he's hungry and thirsty for the championship for the third time.
And finally, the ladies.
We're not quite sure who's going to be in attendance this year, but we believe the AZ, Anna Zerpolo, will be back to defend her title of 2013.
But we've got a newcomer this year. A dark horse, if you want to call her that. And she's going to go for the gold. Brenda
Ruckman, you best be ready.
Also believed to be in attendance this year, the Blue Spring South ladies. Judging by their showing at state, they're fit and they're ready for gold.
You better believe it.
Be ready.
It's gonna happen.
The Nog Mile's coming soon.
We're gonna get a whole bunch of people out there. There's gonna be puke, there's gonna be fun, there's gonna be blood. There's gonna be championships.
It's coming at you like a freight train.
Yeah.
You don't even know it's coming for you yet.
Yeah, it's just blindsided. You're gonna start slurping on some Nog. Get ready, slurp, slurp, slurp.
They'll start honking at you.
Dude, we'll start getting inside.
Train's coming through town.
I'm getting in there right now.
This year's course, exact same as last year's. And the year before that. And the year before that. And the year before that.
It's pretty rough. The horses left-hand turns. You never know when they're gonna come up on you.
Puke stains still cover the track.
All over the place.
All over.
Inside of ourselves.
Outside of ourselves.
Both. Man, how do you think the competition is going to handle this course, Cole?
I don't know. I mean, it's the same as last year, but last year's conditions, you never know. There could be snow on the track course.
Man, that's awful. It's really, really, really flat.
Dumbest thing I've ever done. We almost forgot the newcomers. So in this course preview, we're going to bring you the newcomers into the race on the men's side.
First up, we've got Ian Fraser. You might think, hey, he's too small, he's too short to be a good runner, but you're wrong. Top 10 at state his senior year, all-state runner, he's a monster. He's gonna go out there, he's gonna kick this course's behind, and he's gonna get inside of us.
Ian Fraser is strong like bull. Next, another newcomer we believe is coming, Max Storms. 10K record at Mizzou, on the track. Kid's an animal. He's qualified for the Olympic trials in the marathon. He's gonna be here December 20th, and he is going to be going for gold.
A little over 200 meters in here on our four loop course.
Right about now is when you start feeling the eggnog churning in your stomach. The throw up starting to come up out of your throat.
So it starts burning down there. You realize, man, am I really built for this?
You start questioning who you are as a person, not just as a runner, but as an individual on this track, 250 meters in.
You'll never be the same again after this race.
It changes men. Some get hair on their chest.
Some lose
drop
it.
A pair.
Some get taller, some get shorter, some break their hammies. I don't know, you never know what's gonna happen. I mean, people have puked before right here in the race. People have been like, man, you know what? I can't do this. And then they do it. Or they fail.
Right
You're
here.
Not gonna fail.
Right here, John Speed asked himself, am I a man? Am I a bigger than a man boy? Look, am I gonna be Jake's potato?
You're right,
you know
he is.
What? He did, he went. Nog spewing down his face. Chin beard. Of Nog. In full.
It was majestic. I'll never forget it.
He had heart and determination. He wanted it more than Jay-Z. Empire State of Mind is what John Speed had.
Coming up here on the start line or the finish rubber first lap. Can you imagine there'll be some tables
you gotta
right
leave
here?
Me in.
Some tables set up right here. Took a whole lot of Nog. It's just gonna be a big old fun time. I'm gonna be slopping on some Nog. I'm gonna be slamming it.
Happens. They get here. Stop.
Oh yeah. Yep. And then gone. Just like that. Just like boom. That quick. Gone. Don't even think about it. You're just gone.
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 Gas!
Gassed.
Gas!
You're gone. Drop the hammer. You're gonna drop the hammer on this race. You're gonna get right here thinking, man, I can't slop on this. I can't throw this down my throat. Yeah, you can. Drop the hammer. Drop the hammer. Drop the hammer. Drop the hammer.
And you will drop the hammer. Be there.
December 20th.
At 1:30 p.m.
bring your own eggnog.
And don't forget
to slurp on it.